Good morning, guys. As you can see, man, you're also the most Paul plant too. Earth is my planet. Back at you guys with a brand new video. And today is finally the first day out of the last seven where it has not been raining. Texas has got hit with a huge rainstorm that's pretty much lasted 7 days straight. There is a break in the rain today, and that is a perfect time to throw some plants in the ground. And boy, do I have a ton of plants in abundance. This has become just my like impromptu plant storage facility, and I really need to handle all of these plants today. I need to throw them in the ground because I'm tired of them looking all junky and messy right here. So that's what we're gonna do today. Let's get it. All right, so here we go, my guys. Plant number one is the Chaste or Vitex tree. And someone actually dropped a comment telling me that I should plant this tree. Little did they know, I actually already have picked it up. This dude is complete with marijuana-esque looking leaf structure, which is definitely needed. And it pops with profuse purple flowers, which look amazing. They're actually cracking off everywhere in my neighborhood and area of Houston, Texas. So today, I'm gonna throw this puppy in the ground. The soil is still moist, so it should be easy to dig. Let's get it.
Oh, surprise, surprise. My predictions were correct. The soil was malleable, wet, and loose, and easily diggable. Now, there were three invasive tallow trees on this side of my property, which I had cut down, and hence why we are here on the side of my property in today's landscape transformation, digging the hole to add another tree where some invasive species were.
All right, so I'm gonna try and orient this dude so this tall, like, leader is pointing in the direction of the stop sign because there's a bunch of open space for it to climb. Let's chuck him in.
All right, so first things first, I slid the Vitex out of the pot and it was root bound as hell. Yes, I got this dude for a steal, half off during the winter. So I've had it in the pot for about two growing seasons. So I had to break up that root ball and really free it from the grips of its own roots. But I chunked it in the direction I saw fit, and then I started to backfill the hole with some dirt. Now, if you guys want to get scientific, the name is Vitex agnus castus, and it is native to the Mediterranean and West Asia. Now, this bad boy has butamous flowers that support honeybees, local bees, and also it supports hummingbirds as well. So that's pretty damn cool. It grows from zone 6 all the way to 9. However, if you live in zone 6 or a cold climate, it will die to the ground in the winter, but will come back. And if you live in central Texas, I wouldn't recommend growing this. It does show some invasive tendencies in rocky limestone areas such as central Texas. But overall, it looks super good in my Houston climate, and I can't wait for it to blossom and look awesome.
And all right, so tree number one is in the ground, which is this Vitex. Now behind me, I have two oak trees that were surrounded like a castle that's being besieged with dead bushes. They got killed in the Texas freeze. So I ripped them out and now I'm gonna throw in yet another tree where they resided. So I'm excited. Let's chunk in the next tree. All right, guys, so here is tree number two, and it's layeth on the groundeth. And this is an eastern redwood tree. Now, I got this bad boy before it leafed out in the winter time, and unfortunately, it's been through some things. So I've had it on the side of my house forever. It's been laying on the ground, so all the leaves are facing one direction. Oh, just like the band. Anyways, guys, this dude is one of the first trees to bloom in the United States, especially in this area of Houston, Texas. And it has purple flowers covering all the branches, and it looks so cool. So this is an edge of the forest dweller.
Oh, like a hobbit.
What? It likes part shade to some sun, which the sun beams in this direction in the morning. So I'm gonna throw this dude in the ground right under this oak tree canopy and get it.
All right, dude. So we're throwing in the Circis canadensis, which is the scientific name of the eastern redbud. And this dude has a huge distribution. I'm talking about all the way from Canada down the East Coast to Texas. If you live in any of these states, you can grow this tree, and I'd recommend it because it is an absolute stunner with its pinkish purple flowers. And not only that, you can evidently eat the flowers, which taste sour, and you can also eat the seed pods, which look like beans, either raw or you can cook them while they're young. Either way, it's amazing. The flowers are bisexual, which is alluring, obviously. And the tree supports native bees. How can you be mad at that? So it will be a while before I see it in all its glory, but for now, it looks good enough in this part shade environment where it can thrive, and I absolutely love the way it looks.
Oh, that looks good. And alrighty, daddy. So now it's time to throw in a tree number three, or three.
Oh, three, y'all.
And this is a Texas olive, also known as a Mexican olive tree. Now the fruit is not for us people, it's for the birds, the bees, and the animals. But this dude does have profuse white flowers that just percolate and pop off it. It's from the SLPC, the Southern Living Plant Collection. And this dude is a perfect native species, just as the Eastern Redbud was as well. Now the reason I'm on this side of my house is because I need something to block this blank wall. There's no windows on it, so a tree growing large and strong in front of this wall will look absolutely wondrous. I want it to be a nice kind of like hedge-like tree, which the Texas olive definitely qualifies for. So without further ado, let's put them in.
All right, this really goes to show how big of a blank space this Texas olive needs to take up. So the theme of today's video pretty much has been small, bituminous looking trees. So the size class of the Texas olive is 12 to 24 feet, and it's called the Cordia boisserii, or some shit like that. But this dude has amazing looking white flowers with the inside looking like some egg yolk. Literally, the flower looks like sunny side up eggs, which is delicious, but not for us humans. It's rather toxic. But for birds, deer, cattle, and small mammals, they can munch on this tree all day long, and evidently it can make deer tipsy, which is absolutely awesome. The native range is to Texas, literally South Texas to the borderlands of northern Mexico, and that's it. But either way, I can't wait for this small fry to develop and produce some of those sunny side up egg flowers.
All right, my guys, so the Mexican olive is in the ground, and it's only right to accentuate it with the Mexican sage. Bah. Anyways, this dude grows 4 feet high to 6 feet wide and has crazy purple flowers. I've been neglecting him, but the rains have allowed this dude to start bussing with the purple flowers. So I wanna go ahead and plant these two massive space fillers up in my garden, and that way the hummingbirds can snort on something nice. Let's do it.
All right, baby, this is called the Salvia lucantha, and I'm putting it in the corner of this little side of my house bed because it is going to grow huge and fill up a lot of space. Again, 4 feet by 6 feet, this dude definitely can start taking over, and that's why I'm not only putting one, but I am putting two to add a nice bit of purple flair in the side portion of my garden. This is the benefit of having a corner lot. This dude needs medium water. It grows in zones 8 through 10, is native to Mexico, but I think it'll be a showstopper in my garden and will definitely be a nice hummingbird feeder, and we'll turn these dudes into some little crack addicts in my yard. Looks good too. Yes. All right, so the next plant we're throwing in the ground is a bituminous shrub. This is called the false indigo, or Amphora fruticosa, and it looks very cool in my humble opinion. I love the leaf structure, and also the flowers are stunners. I'm telling you guys, they attract a large array and variety of butterflies and moths. They're larval host plants for a ton of species, too many to name. Just look at all these dudes, and it's probably because the native distribution and range of this false indigo is the contiguous United States. Literally every state and all the way up into Canada is where this can grow, which is awesome. It's a nitrogen fixer. It adds a nice little bit of structure to the garden. And overall, I can't wait to watch it take off and explode. Also, if you guys have a pond or water garden, this dude is an aquatic plant as well, so it'll love it.
Now you guys know, a pop of color can make all the difference in a garden. And I need things that'll attract pollinators and beneficial insects to pollinate all the fruit trees I'm throwing in the ground. So right here we have the sombrero salsa red coneflower. Now, I think this is the wrong color that they threw in here, but either way, this is a species native to America. It's hybridized, but it also is amazing. Just look at the flowers. This dude is popping off.
So I have to throw this perennial in the ground and watch it thrive. It'll add a nice pop to the entrance of my garden. Oh wow, and it smells really good too. So yeah, I want to border the whole garden with some flowers, starting with this salsa, I guess, yellow coneflower.
I'm not even gonna lie, dude. I spent $15 on this hybrid coneflower, which is crazy. But the blooms are also crazy. The flowers are fat, huge, and will absolutely break the necks of my neighbors walking their dogs by my property. This thing is a showstopper. Bright yellow, looking like some damn cheese. I absolutely love it.
All right, perfection. So we have the beautiful salsa yellow, or I guess queso yellow coneflower. And now I'm throwing in two of these spin top red blanket flowers as well. So these dudes actually are red, and I think they'll have a nice mustard and ketchup dynamic sitting right beside the beautiful queso coneflower. So I'm gonna throw both of these guys in the ground. I'll probably need to deadhead them because they have bloomed in certain areas. But yeah, I'm excited to have a nice flower border. So let's throw them in.
Okay, this is the perfect genre of flower to throw in. It has a red eye surrounded by yellow, and these dudes were super root bound. That's how long they're sitting in my driveway, but it is nice to finally get them in the ground, and hopefully they will continue to bloom. These can grow in zones 3 through 9 because they are a Monrovia exclusive, so obviously they want to sell their product to as many people in the United States as possible. And honestly, hats off to them for coming through with the native species Gaillardia arstata, which looks awesome, and through selective breeding, they've came up with such a versatile and hardy flower, which is amazing. Can't wait to watch some butterflies mess with it, sip on that sweet nectar, and yeah, dude, it's another banger in the garden, bitch.
So there we have it, man. Queso and salsa accents. Oh man, that's one way to have a delicious garden, if I say so myself. Now the next plant we're throwing in is the Texas rock rose. Again, you got the flowers in the front, rock rose in the middle, salvia farinaceae in the back, then a loquat behind that. That's what we call stair stepping with the structure. Let's get them in.
All right, so the Texas rock rose can grow 4 feet tall. It's called the Pavonia lacipotala. That is just a mouthful, let me tell you. But it does have amazing pink flowers. I planted two of these already in my landscape. It's originally native to Texas, so it's nice to have a nice little Texas breed in my Texas garden, goddammit. So yeah, I think this dude will fill in the space nicely and look super, super good. Hell, it already does.
All right, guys. And last but certainly not least, man, we're gonna wrap this up with a couple of Mesa blanket flowers. Again, a nice perennial flower variety. And these dudes have already bloomed, blossomed, and now they look like this. So you wanna plant them, deadhead them, and then watch them develop as time goes on. But let's put these two in the ground.
All right, so these blanket flowers are extremely similar to the others I threw in the ground. They already have bloomed on the side of my driveway, but hopefully they bloom some more. And to encourage that, I will deadhead all the flowers that have already bloomed, which means just cut the tops off these guys, which encourages more blossoms. And you can already see there's a few more about to come in, my friend. Hell yeah.
Dude, and there it is, ladies and gentlemen, another episode of Paul Plant 2 is in the books. We got in 3 trees, probably like 5-6 shrubs, a bunch of flowering plants, and I've somewhat cleared out the area beside my garage. Now you guys stay tuned because I am going to have a lot more videos coming soon. It was nice to find a break in the 7-day straight rain streak to actually do this. If you guys did enjoy, please hit the like button. Again, this is a small channel, so that is the best way to help me grow. Anyways, I love you guys. Always remember, Earth is my planet.
Earth is my planet.
Drop a comment with any planting advice or plant suggestions. And until next time, I'm locked, I'm loaded, and I'm out. Peace.
Killing these songs, leaving a bloody life I roost to. And I'm in it to win it, so I'm somebody that you should get used to. Should get used to, should get used to.